Well, it's a market which is multifaceted, no question about it. Marijuana has supporters who are making a lot of money. The drug also has its share of detractors who long for the days of pot prohibition. Here's some things you'll want to keep in mind when you head out to cast your vote today in Ohio. The good, the bad, and whatever lies in between. When it comes to marijuana legalization, I've gotten an earful and an eyeful during my time in Colorado.
A lot of our detractors before marijuana really took hold in this state and started to show a lot of positive benefits to our economy and to our citizens. There was a lot of this sky is going to fall mentality that was going on, a lot of fear of a lot of addicts running the streets, sort of a reefer madness scenario. It simply hasn't happened. Life has really just continued on as normal.
What is the negative impacts of what we've done? So we need to emphasize sobriety, alcohol, tobacco, total sobriety. There's ways of fixing things, but you don't have to legalize it. We don't have to go that extreme. You know, if you don't like all of prohibition, we can talk about how can we modify this and modify that.
Well, those are two people on opposite sides of the fence when it comes to Colorado's legal marijuana marketplace, but they're both connected to it in different ways. One works in the industry, the other has a job to protect the public. I'll share more views from Colorado talking about marijuana coming up later on this evening on News 5. Until then, I'm Todd Dykes from Colorado, WLWT News 5.